explain about the memory segmentation of the 8086. Okay. Coming to the 8086, the address bus width of the 8086 is 20 bit. Okay, 20 bit. So maximum storage capacity of is 24 address bus, that is called 24/21 MB. The maximum storage capacity of the 8086 microprocessor is 1 MB. Okay, memory segmentation. The basic idea behind this memory segmentation is nothing but the to calculate the 20-bit physical address. Okay, we cannot able to store the 20-bit address in 16-bit registers. We cannot able to store the 20-bit address in 16-bit register. By using this memory segmentation, what we are doing, we are calculating the 20-bit physical address by using the formula 10H into base address plus 10H into base address plus offset address. Okay, this base address, is stored in the segment register. Okay, coming to this memory segmentation, the maximum storage capacity of the 8086 is 1 MB. Okay, this total 1 MB is divided into the 16 logical segment, each of the 64K. How many logical segment? I'm dividing into 16 logical segment. So each one consists of the 64 KB. How we are going to be total 1 MB? 1 MB is nothing but the 2/20 by how many segments we are dividing? 2/4. 2/20 by 2/4. That is nothing but the 2/16. That is nothing but 2/6 into 2/10. Okay. 2/6, 2, 4, 6, 8. That is 64. 2/10 is nothing but K. Okay. Each segment, this segment memory is 64K. These in 16 logical segments, we are using only 4 segments. Okay. In this 4 segment, first segment, second one is data segment, stack segment, extra segment. We are using only 4 segments we are using. This first one is the code segment, second one is the data segment, third one is the stack segment, fourth one is the extra segment. Okay, coming to the code segment. In this code segment, whatever the code, program code is stored in this code segment. Okay, next one is the data segment. The data value is stored in the data segment. Okay, stack segment. The stack value, while writing the program, any stack value, that stack value is stored in the stack segment. Extra value is stored in the extra segment. Okay, where you are storing the program code in code segment, input values in data segment. Okay, stack values in stack segment, extra values in extra segment we are storing. Okay, these large segments are all are logical. The physical and logical, the difference is, what is the difference between physical segments and logical segments? Okay, physical and logical means, physical means the position of the segment is fixed. Suppose if you take the entire memory, this is 1 MB memory. Suppose if I say the segmentation is based on the physical, physical means this, once this memory location, this position is allocated for the code segment, means only code segment we have to use. But these are the logical segment. We can define anywhere in 1 MB memory location. So that is the difference between the physical segments and logical segment. Physical segment means we are fixing the position, we are fixing the memory location allocated for that segment. Coming to the logical, logical means we can define anywhere in this 1 MB memory. Okay, that is difference between the logical segment and physical segment. Okay, next, how we are giving the segmentation? Okay, right. First, before doing the segmentation, for 1 MB memory, we need to calculate what is the starting address and what is the ending address. Before that, simple example I will give you. Suppose I am taking, this is a memory device. It consists of 8 bytes of data. Means how many memory locations are there? Each and every, in each and every memory location we can able to store 1 byte of data. Okay, only 8 bits data we can able to store if you take any memory location. Total, this is a memory chip capacity is 8 bytes. So how many memory locations? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Total 8 memory locations are there. In each and every memory location we are storing 1 byte. So it is 8 bytes. Okay, how we are giving the address 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 like that. Okay, suppose I am taking 10 bytes of data. 10 bytes of data means total how many memory locations? 0 to 9 we are going to give. Suppose 16 bytes of data. 0 to 15. But in generally 8086 we are using the number system is hexadecimal. So 0 to F memory location. 15 is nothing but the 0 to F. Okay. How we are going to calculate the starting address and ending address for one device? Suppose I am taking one memory chip. This is I am taking one memory device. Memory device capacity is 1 KB. 1 KB means 2 power 10. That is nothing but 1024 bytes. 1024 bytes. Total how many memory locations are there? Total how many memory locations? Total 1024 memory locations are there in 1 KB memory. Those are nothing but the 0 to 1020. 0 to 1023. Okay? 0 to 1023 in decimal. But which number system we are using to represent hexadecimal number? Okay? To calculate the starting address and ending address, it is very simple. To calculate the starting address, 1 KB means 2 power 10. We have to take 10 zeros. We have to take 10 ones. Convert this value into the hexadecimal. One hexadecimal digit is represented by 4 binary bits. So split this one. F, F, 3. 0, 0, 0. So if you take 1 KB memory, starting address is 0H2, 3FFH. Convert this 1023 into the hexadecimal. 16, 16, 6 are 96, 4 less, 96, 4, 42, 16, 2 are 32, 16, 2 are 32, 10, 13, 15, 16, 2 are 32, 10, 13, 15, sorry, if you convert. If you take in decimal, it is 1023, convert to hexadecimal. 16 3s are 96, 63, 63 are 48, remainder is 15, 15 equivalent to hexadecimal is F, 63 are 48, remainder is 15, 3FF, okay, 1023, in hexadecimal, 0H2, 3FFH, okay. Coming to the same, what is the maximum storage capacity of the 8086? Maximum storage capacity of the 8086 is 1 MB. Maximum storage capacity of 8086 is 1 MB. To calculate the starting address and ending address, 1 MB means 2 power 20. Take 20 zeros. 0, 0, 0, 0, 5, 5, 0H2, 5FH. What is the starting address and ending address of 1 MB memory? That is nothing but 8086. The starting address is 50H2, 5FH. This is the addressing of the 1 MB memory. Coming to the segmentation part, so when we are storing the starting address of the each segment, we are storing in the segment register. Suppose I am taking 4 segment register is 2000, data segment register is 3000, extra segment register is 4000, stack segment register is 5000. Okay, each segment register starting at the sys node in the segment register. Here I am taking this is the 1 MB. Here starting address is 50H2 5FH. Okay, code segment register 2000H. Okay, so append 0. Code segment, where we are starting the code segment? Code segment we are starting in 20000H. To calculate the 20 bit physical address, what we are doing? 10H into base address plus 10H into base address plus offset address. Okay, append 0 or multiply by 10 to the basic address. We are going to calculate the starting address of the code segment. Code segment, what is the capacity of the each and every segment? 64K. 64K. 64K means 2 power 16. Starting address is 4 zeros. Ending address is 4F. So here we are starting the code segment. Code segment is where we are starting at 20000H. What is the capacity of this one is 64K. The starting address is 406. What is the ending address for 64KB? 4FH. Here starting address is 20000H. To calculate the ending address, add 20000 to this one. Okay, what is the ending address of the code segment? 2 4FH. This is the code segment. Okay, next data segment. Where we are starting the data segment? 30000. Okay, what is the capacity here? It is also 64K. Okay, means add 4X like this. Suppose I am taking extra segment, I am taking extra segment in between. These segments may be overlapped, not these are not physically different, these are logically different. Why? Because we are taking the segment register content, so that place only we are starting the starting address. Suppose I am taking here, this one is 6000. Okay, extra segment, you can start with 60000. Okay, it is 64K. 64FH. This is extra segment. Here this one is start segment. Start segment is 40,000 to 4FH. Suppose this way we are doing the segmentation. Okay, memory segmentation is nothing but we are calculating the 20 bit physical address by using 260 bit register. The base address always is stored in the segment register. Okay, the starting address of the segment is stored in the that segment register. Core segment starting address is stored in the core segment register. So what is the starting address in 20 bit? Append 0, 20000H. What is the capacity of the core segment? It is a 64K. 64 means 2 power 16. Convert into the memory, 20, 16 zeros and 16 ones. So 40H to 4FH. Okay, the starting address is 40H, ending address is 4FH. Here what we are taking? Starting address is 20000H. So what is the ending address? 2 for 20,000 as 4FH. In this way we are going to get the ending address of the code segment. Suppose if I am taking the code segment address is 1254H. 1254H. What is the ending address? 1254H. So the starting address of the code segment 12540H. 12540H. Suppose for 64KB, starting address is 4 zeros, ending address is 4. Starting address is 12540. So we are adding 4. F. F plus 4, 15 plus 4, 19. Convert 19 into the exact address, 1613. 3 is sum, 1 is carry. 15 plus 1, 16. 16 plus 21. 16, 1, 16. 5. 5, 1, 15, 16, 18, 1, 2, 2, 1. This is the ending address. 2, 2, 5, 3, FH is the ending address of the code segment. In this way, we are doing the segmentation of the 8086. These are the non-overlapping segments. These are the non-overlapping segment means if you observe code segment, data segment, extra segment and start segment separately we are declaring. If you declare any one of the segment in between any segment, that is nothing but the overlapping segment. Suppose here extra segment is suppose I am defining extra segment in between the code segment. Start from the 1 to 13,000 each. Okay. In this case, the segmentation is known as the overlapping segmentation. Okay. It's not the 90, 86. Thank you.